In Unit 4, you mentioned that you would tend to store the secret key in a completely separate machine from the one you were developing on. And you mentioned the concept of a production machine. And some of our students were wondering if you could go into that a bit more in depth.
Sure, sure. We can definitely talk about that. There's a few little edge cases, nothing major, that we'll talk about here on the whiteboard, and it should help you out. So how to have a distinction between production and development. The way we've always structured stuff on my projects is we'll have a file. Usually we call it like, you know, production.py. And depending on the framework we're using, sometimes this kind of notion is built in. You know, when you launch your program locally, you say something like dev, app, whatever. I don't know. I always tab complete it. And you can give it a bunch of configuration options. Often you can give it a configuration file as well. This isn't always the case. Sometimes what we do is, in the simple case, we just have production.py.py. You know, we'll have devel.py. And these are both basically have a bunch of global variables, things like secret keys that you're going to use for your cookies or your passwords, that sort of thing. And we'll have one that's only used in production and one that's only used in development. And this one may be included on our repository, and this one may only exist on our servers, or may exist in our repository, but generally we don't like that stuff getting shared around, especially if it's open source. For example, Reddit's open source, so we don't include production.py publicly, but I think we do include a development.py for you guys to use locally. And then when we deploy code on our own machines, we just symlink, to config.py, whichever one we want. So I think our apps by default look for devel.py, and if it's not there, it uses config.py, which may symlink to like production.py. And we also have a bunch of different configuration files, whether you're an app server or whether you're a database, or because we have all these different machines that serve different purposes. So I put all my stuff in one module, and then we have this complicated symlink setup when we do deployments that basically says this app server is doing this job, therefore it should use this file. And you can copy it in place, you can symlink it, you can do all sorts of clever stuff. Sometimes it's built into the framework. On Hipmunk, it's built into the framework. We just say, ff.py is the name of our main executable. And I can just say dash 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 config equals, and then we specify one of these files. And that works great. So there's no easy, correct answer, simple thing. You just store your globals in different files if you want to keep them secret, and then when you're deploying it, kind of figure out how to decide which file you want to use. So hope that helps.